Naked Crazy Guy from YouTube again. Actually, I haven't done a video of this kind in over a year, I think, and I watched one of the very, very first videos which I did on my channel 2 years, almost 3 years ago. I watched it today. Actually, it was not that bad after all. Maybe the sound was a bit low, but yeah, I expected it to be much worse. I will put a link here in the description. Also, try to give you a bit of an impression here. At very first, let's start and talk a bit about scaling, because I often say this and I repeat myself over and over about this, because this is a really important topic. I say you should not slave yourself to the scale, and you should actually understand what you do when you scale and which importance you can put into the numbers. And basically what you do every time you scale, you give yourself a data point from a certain point of the day, of the week. So like if I escaped right now, I can say this is my rate at this moment, but is this truly my rate? And how comparable is this number, like the 200, what do I have today, 255.7 pounds, which I had this morning. How well can I compare this with other data points, other people, and other scalings I did myself? So what you should do when you use the scale is like do it in a regular interval, and like do it on the same time of the day. Like if you want to scale every Sunday, this is probably fine, Sunday morning or something like this. And if you do scale daily like I do, you should think about something to normalize the numbers, because from day to day there can be quite big differences in your morning weight. For example, I started intermittent fasting last week, and I went down like 7 pounds, which was the first time I measured my weight. But this was mostly because the times before I have been eating much in the evening, and now I switched from only eating in the morning till midday. So I cannot really compare this data, even if it's the same time of the day. My habits have changed, so what seems to be a huge weight loss is actually just a false positive here, because I changed my habits, and so I have less content in my stomach and stuff. So probably lose a bit of weight, but not 7 pounds. So, yeah, I recently bought me such a weighing scale, which I saw on sale. I would not really recommend them if you want more precise scaling, because honestly, they are extremely expensive, and the only thing they do for you is put your data into your apps, which you can do by hand. So, because my old scale, which I used before here, which was like 20 euros or something, yeah, does a fine job well. And actually, if you compare the results, they are much more constant than this one. So sometimes if you step 3 times on the scale on the same time, it can show you 3 different results, and here you get 3 times the same result. At home I have another scale, a Tenida one, which I wanted to show for a while, till I found out that this they have a different model for the US and for Europe. So the Europe model is much nicer, and yeah, so it cannot be really compared. But I probably will show it in another video, because I really like the scale, and if you want to invest like $200 or euros into a scale, I would much rather recommend that scale compared to Whiting. If you scale regularly, you should make comparable data points. If you scale every time in the morning, that's fine. If you scale every time in the evening, that's fine as well. But it's probably difficult to compare, like if I scale on Monday morning and on Sunday evening, these results are not really comparable. And in the same way, when you compare your weight to the weight of other persons, the weight does not say so much. So, for example, with my 256 pounds I have at the moment, if I would be a top athlete, this would probably be just fine, or just muscle mass, but obviously it's not. So now I scale in the morning, as I said. I use an app called Libra, I think on Android, and I really like it because it's simple and really does the job, because what Bossy does for me is a normalized weight, like a trend weight where I am, and I usually use this to think about my weight, so I don't use the weight from one, but I use this normalized weight where the big ups and downs are cut out, and this is what I handle as my usual weight for all the stuff. So keep that in mind, because I write the numbers there. So now I'm 255.7 in the trend at the moment, or 116 kilograms. Back in my first video, in May 2014, I was at 270 pounds. So in the 2 years, I managed to get up and down. But I have a downward scale and a downward direction in the, if you put a normalizing table, there is a downward direction. But if I would continue on this rate, I would reach my goal weight at around, probably when I hit 40 or something. So I think I really need to amp it up a bit. And I think this year really started fantastic till now. So, I'm really looking forward to getting it done this year. And another thing about scaling, what you really should get yourself is a tape measure, because actually I got this one for free from my healthcare, and you get them for like 20 cents, and I got one from IKEA, which is nice because it has inches and millimeters. It's only metric. I just put in a quick measurement. I did another measuring some time ago, so I'm around 101 centimeters right now, but I didn't do it this morning. It's about 40 inches. And this is actually right in the area where you go from deep red to not as red. So yeah, that's something I have been looking on to much last year. And this is, it's not as easy to compare and to measure as a scale, but you should always check this, because could be that you do something wrong. And for most people, the belly fat is the most important thing to lose, the most dangerous thing to your head. So let's see a bit. I don't see such a big difference to the video from 2 years ago. So the about 14 pounds less. I don't see it so much, but it's really hard to compare. So I put the video. I will try to get the video side by side. Close by each other, so you can see what's developing. So, said, I had a really good start, mostly with Kim Monica's squat challenge, which really, really gave me a huge motivation. So huge that I went on Friday and checked all the video of her from January, which I missed with all the vacation and kids. And yeah, and about intermittent fasting. And I have been interested in intermittent fasting for quite a while. The thing is, everybody does it a bit different. There are people who do 24 hours, then eat. I think most common at the moment is something like 8 hours eating, 16 hours fasting, which I'm doing now. And I was mostly not ready to do it, because of those pictures like you only eat from midnight till 8 in the morning, and this would absolutely not fit into my lifestyle at any point. So this was the main reason I didn't invest more time into the topic. And I watched the videos, and some videos she linked on her video, so I will link this video here as well on the info card and in the description below. So I watched the videos she posted there as information basis, and yeah, I think what I'm doing now since Friday, so for like 5 days now, is that I eat from 6 to 2 p.m. from 6 in the morning till 2 p.m. And then I fasten. This is actually not so different from the lifestyle I had before in the times I was doing really good. With one difference, that I mostly screwed it up on the weekends. So this is the most important things that I keep this going on the weekends as well. So then let's see how this develops. And this is the main reason I want to show you my body so I can see and you can see if this intermittent fasting is helping me get this body into a better shape. As I said, intermittent fasting, the way I do it now, 6 a.m. till 2 p.m. Let's see how this works out in the coming weeks. The squat challenge, it goes well as well. I did 185 squats today. Yeah, thank you very much for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. Check out the videos I put in the description. My bad old videos. Kim Monica's video about intermittent fasting. If you're into it or interested. I cannot say so much. So I'm hungry at the moment. Sometimes, but it's not like killing me. So yeah, it goes well, but it's just 5 days in. So see you guys soon. Thank you very much for watching, and bye bye.